So, we get back to Vicarious Visions. After doing Huge Adventure, their first game in the Crash series they produced, I had a pretty low opinion of what they had made due to very little of anything being unique that they added to the franchise amongst many other things, so this wasn't exactly them starting out on a good footing. Huge Adventure was incredibly short, hitting the credits at around 2 hours of play. It was ugly looking, incredibly boring, with none of the comedic writing or timing that had made Crash stand out amongst the crowd of mascot platformers back in the day. And after looking at their credits at the time during the mid-2000s, Vicarious Visions looked exactly like N-Space, where they were doing lowest bid and licensed game work, pumping out up to 5 games a year, which is completely ridiculous, so I came into this thinking it would be a complete trilogy of error and a full black mark on the franchise's attempt to go handheld. However, while I was working on going through the footage and taking some notes for this video, it seemed that someone had decided to try and turn things around and have the Crash team toss a bit more effort into what they were doing, because after concluding the review of the footage, my ultimate thought about it was that compared to Huge Adventure, Entrance was a pretty obvious step up from their previous work. Now, it's definitely not like Vicarious pulled out anything truly extraordinary on the level of Twin Sanity, but I think they should earn points nonetheless under the circumstance that they had less than a year to put this thing together, probably with a small team due to Vicarious working on multiple games all the time up till 2010 or so. Entrance is still borrowing pretty much every goddamn thing that's in it from the original Crash trilogy with very little added to it to make Entrance its own game beyond the premise of the game. And even then, it's still the classic Crash formula of a ridiculous problem getting solved entirely through gathering crystals. But what they decide to translate over to the GBA shows that they didn't do it entirely to be lazy. Instead of the game being 85% or more of just 2D platforming levels that do nothing but fill time and look just good enough for the player to think that they're having a good time while not really doing much to entertain themselves, they did start adding in the 3D gimmick levels as well, and the game now had quite a few of those flying vehicle levels from other Crash games, and the shoot 'em up bits as well. Plus, the themes that Vicarious pulled for the levels themselves made the game look a lot better since they were more of the fantastical levels, such as the Egyptian level from Crash's World Tour. It was a good thing to see, since the more fantasy the location they put in meant that the game had brighter, more interesting backgrounds that needed to have more details put in to make the translation work. And ultimately, it started making Vicarious's Crash game look like good pixel art rather than the crap they had in Huge Adventure. One of my personal favorite areas of improvement was Entrance's water art, which looks great for the game's jet skiing levels on top of the good background art. Again, there's nothing really groundbreaking here since this is the same world-building model as the frickin' N64 skyboxes, but I'm counting as many pluses as I can, frankly, because I don't want to be stuck looking at N-Space's little brother for the next 5 minutes. The presentation of the plot also went up a notch as well, because while Entrance is still using the Huge Adventure tech screens as a means of replacing cutscenes in their game, Vicarious at least spent the small amount of time to try and animate the characters talking to each other and showing more than one character on the screen at a time as a means of making them look like they're talking to each other, and Vicarious actually did decide to create a brand new villain character for this game that's the main antagonist if you don't go through the rigmarole of 100% completion. And that's where I think I can go from giving Vicarious Visions credit for trying with making this game rather than just crapping something out. Because even after all that effort that one person put in to try and give everybody the motivation to get creative with this one, Entrance is still crap. Objectively, Entrance is most likely going to be looked at as a mediocre game that shouldn't be bothered with by anybody, and even during my attempts to be positive, I could only just barely stop giving this game backhanded compliments. The more obvious one being that the plot of the game still sucks and fundamentally misses the point of the series by not bothering with any jokes whatsoever, and this is on a game with a plot delivered via text only, meaning that all they needed was somebody, just one person, to write a few jokes for this game. This game mostly has text dumps between boss fights, of which there are four, and the beginning of the game. This isn't all that hard to do, but apparently the resources of Crash's console days were simply not available to this team for whatever reason. The plot, like Huge Adventure, is cartoonishly ridiculous while also being dull as dirt somehow. Instead of the entire cast of vintage villains coming back from the original trilogy in Huge Adventure somewhat, instead the villains of this game is the Crash family, and that is because the new villain Ventrance is hired by Entropy to hypnotize the Bandicoots in order to destroy Crash. But these guys failed so badly that they were actually being defeated faster than the bosses in Huge Adventure. Coco's boss fight was particularly boring, because it was a very slow-moving submarine that you just bullied around for a minute. Furthermore, while Entrance does mix things up with adding gimmick levels on top of the usual platforming stuff, and have some more complicated mechanics in the game, it still has the same level count as Huge Adventure, making this game still comically short. Again, if you don't care about 100% completing the game to get to the final area, and the true ending of the game in a game this mediocre, then the full game nets you another 2 hours of time killed. Again, this is a GBA game, and exactly like in Huge Adventure's case, this is unacceptably limited content on a console where its competition is defeating it instantly when it hits the market. There are higher standards for this console, and at some point, this game was probably getting sold near launch prices, and people just expect better from the console that has a bunch of the classic SNES Mario platformers on it, Pokemon, and freaking Mario and Luigi games on it. It's just that simple. Even though it's improved substantially, Entrance is still bottom shelf grade product, produced by a team that doesn't have the time to add genuine creativity to any of their projects. And the best example of that is Entrance himself. Vicarious had the opportunity to add a totally new villain to the legacy roster alongside Entropy, and could do probably whatever the hell they wanted in a cartoon fashion to fit the franchise that it's licensing for. And Entrance was what we got out of that. Entrance has a terrible design, completely lazy compared to Entropy, with a design that is clearly worth of being iconic. Entrance looks like an egg that Vicarious stuck a face on and then slapped it on a bad cyborg body. He has no personality because the writing of the only game he's in only just moves the plot along and doesn't do any character interaction whatsoever. We don't know what the hell his old deal is, what he likes, what he dislikes, whatever his character traits are, because the only thing that's in the game story-wise is the plot itself. And then his combat abilities are boring as hell. He swings from baby easy to avoid to arbitrarily difficult, with his grapple arms and his energy attacks. It's not exactly fair in a game that will only rarely give you 3 hits max until you die that you got all this bullet hell nonsense to deal with. Entrance gets defeated once in a short amount of time and then disappears forever, not even bothering to say bye on the way out. And lastly, the same stupid tradition that Vicarious is trying to make a thing applies to Entrance as well. In order to see the final boss and the actual ending, you need to get 100% of all the gems in the game. And while it is only 20 levels to do that all in, I'm looking at this 2-hour game and thinking that only the most diehard appreciators would even begin to bother with doing that. Kind of a waste that Vicarious keeps trying to make this a thing, and what's most likely going to happen is that less than 10%, hell 5%, of this game's players will even see the work they put in to slap that final world of levels together. And Entropy himself, which is lame, since Entropy is usually a sweet villain to fight against. I'm sure Vicarious would have screwed it up, but why the hell are you freaking completion wall blocking the Entropy final boss fight when he actually has unique mechanics that you can use? You would have used them, but I mean, come on. This is like the thing that we want to see. This guy is the poster boy for the whole game. it's completely mind-boggling that people keep doing this, because you put work in to do the bonus content, but no one's bothering with it because the game's bad. So, while a few things have been moderately improved from Huge Adventure, the inherent laziness and lacking in creativity is found in Entrance, with short levels of which some are repetitive and none are memorable, lacking an art style that people will remember, its short and dull as hell story, mediocre tech screens and animation, and simply its bad villains, its bad licensed villains. The more that Vicarious kept thinking they could make all sorts of money just pumping product out the door, the more time they were doing damage to their own brand, which seemingly recovered after they were put on Activision's Skylanders project for the last 6 or 7 years. While Entrance is specifically not embarrassing, it's definitely not a game that anyone should bother looking into, free or otherwise. Do not buy this game, as a rule, not even close. No money for this one. Because this game is the video game equivalent of white noise and filler time. And what's most frustrating of all is that it's so boring and short that the game can't even provide an afternoon's amount of time without putting actual completionist labor into it. The final Crash game up until now, maybe Activision will put out a new platform for this franchise, who really knows, is going to be Crash's Vicarious made crossover with Spyro on the GBA again. And I can't imagine how that's going to turn out, with these last two games already getting put in the books with very bright red ink slathered all over them. So here's a final scoreboard before that happens for Entrance. And I'll wish you all out there a victory for gamers. I hope you all have a good evening.